In this video, I'm gonna show you how to use the preset page and the profiling page. So firstly, the preset page is right here. So you can see the preset profiles, that's the like most popular ones right here. So if you want to make a shot with the profile, you can just choose one and then tap OK and then start the shot by the group head controller or the tablet button. But if you have group head controller, then the tablet start button will not be activated. So you should use the group head controller. And actually there are like a lot more profiles than just those popular ones. So if you want to see the hidden profiles, you just need to tap this I button like this. Then you can see all the profiles that this Espresso has as the presets. So if you want to bring one preset to the default presets, then you can just tap the profile to activate it. So you can see it's X'd on the box. And then if you tap the eye icon again, then you can see this profile is in the default preset. Next thing is how to use the profile editor. For the pressure profile and the flow profile only, advanced profile has got like a lot of information. So I'll just make another video only for the advanced profiling. If you choose just one pressure profile and then go to profile editor, then you can just edit it on here. Or you can also tap this plus icon. Then you can pick the kind of the preset. So if you tap pressure, then it'll go to the pressure profile editor. Or if you tap flow, even though the preset is just pressure profile, but if you tap flow on here, then it'll change to the flow profile. So this is just pressure profile. So on here you can edit the preinfusion step. So you can move the bar on here, the scroll bar, to change the time of the preinfusion. Or you can move this one to change the flow rate of the preinfusion. And this is the exit pressure. So if the pressure hits the four bar on here, then it'll move to the next stage, even though it's before 22 seconds. Or if it doesn't hit 4 bar for 22 seconds or 20 seconds, then it'll move to the next stage. So which one reaches the first will be the trigger. And this is the second step, rise and hold. You can also edit the time on here, and then you can edit the pressure on here. So it's the pressure goal. The machine will change the flow rate automatically to reach and hold the pressure. And this is the limit flow. So what it does is, if you set 9 bar, but if the puck is not like dense enough, so for example, if the ground is not fine enough, or if you didn't use like enough dose of the coffee bean, then the machine will need to like push a lot of water at the same time. So it'll require like higher flow rate than you expect. Then it can go like 6 ml/s to reach and hold the 9 bar. But that'll like kind of ruin the shot, because the flow rate is too fast, then the shot time will be like a lot shorter. It cannot even go for like 25 seconds. It can finish at like 10 or 5 seconds or something. So that this limit flow limits the maximum flow that the machine can do. So that even though it cannot reach 9 bar, it won't go like higher than 4.5 ms/s of flow rate. So you can lower it or just higher it, or just you can turn it off. And this is the decline stage. Decline stage is mostly used for the pressure profile, but for the Italian, like classic Italian espresso, there is no decline stage. So decline stage is like smoothly lower the pressure to the gold pressure right here, so 6 bar. So it'll slowly lower the pressure from 9 bars to 6 bar for 10 seconds. That's for like lowering the flow rate actually. So during the shot, as the time goes, the flow rate will be faster. But as you set the decline on here, the flow rate will be like stable. But if you don't want it, then you can turn it off. And there is stop at 4, because the scale is now connected to this app. But if the scale is connected to this app, then it'll change to stop at wait. So the stop at 4 is like the machine will calculate the water used for the shot. So if the machine used like 36 milliliters of water during the rise and hold stage, actually the preinfusion stage will be just skipped to calculate this. So if the machine used 36 milliliters of water during the rise and hold stage, it'll finish the shot automatically even though it doesn't reach this time. And there is the temperature, so you can higher the temperature, lower the temperature in like 0.5 degrees Celsius unit or like 0.5 Fahrenheit unit. And if you tap in the middle of the thermometer icon, then you can actually change the temperature in each step. So, but if you activate this one, you will have the 2 seconds of start stage to build up the temperature, and you can just change the temperature for the each stage. But the most important thing is the machine only can do what really can happen. So even though you set the temperature like this, it's really hard to just change from 94 degrees Celsius to 36 degrees Celsius immediately, so it won't happen. But the machine will try to like drop the temperature, so you can just control the temperature at each step on here. And let's see the flow profile page. So plus flow, then there will be flow profile. Everything is the same except for these two and this one here. So previously on the pressure profile, the exit pressure was on here, but now exit pressure is on here and the flow rate setting is on here. Previously it was the pressure setting on the pressure profile, but it changes to flow rate setting. So it's now at like 1.8 meter per second, and there is no limit pressure, which means even though the pressure goes really high, the machine will try to keep the 1.8 meter per second of the flow rate. But if you don't want really high pressure, then you can set the limit pressure like this. The machine won't go above 9.0 bar, even though the flow rate is lower than 1.8 meter per second. And the other thing is the same decline. You can set the decline flow rate on here, but it's not really used. The flow profile can like make the flow rate consistently until the end of the shot, so it don't go faster like the pressure profile. So the decline step in the flow profile is not really like widely used. And if you edit something, then there will be this kind of star icon on here. And if you tap on here, the profile will be saved. And then if you go to preset, then there is the saved profile. And then you can change the name on here. And tap this piggy bank icon, then it'll be saved like this. So as soon as you make any change on the profile, then you can see there's the star icon appeared, then you can tap to save it. That's it. Thank you.